We are going to see about the comparison function Python screen. So normally comparison functions produce output in true or false. Based on the particular function, it will produce the true or false function of output. So in string, is lower, is upper, is decimal, is digit, is alpha, and is all num. So these are the function used to perform the comparison operator in particular string. So we see example for LP function. So we see one by one. First we are going to see about is lower function. Normally we check the particular string, so every character. So here every character is a small letter means it will produce a true in our output. Suppose there is one character we start with uppercase mean, it automatically produce a false in our output. So we see the example for it. Now I take it a variable I, start with I smaller letters. I give all the string is small character, and after I create the J variable. So I start with first character is uppercase. Now we use to check the print I variable dot is lower function. So here check with I variables, every character is small letter, that means it produces a true in our output. Now I check with J variable is lower function, by using the lower function. So here first letter start with uppercase, that means it automatically produces a false in output because it start with uppercase. So it automatically produces a false in output. So now we are going to see about the is uppercase. So uppercase function used to check all the characters are uppercase. Suppose all the characters are particular string means it produces the true in our output. Suppose there is some small letter present in our particular string means it automatically produces a false in our output. So we see the example for it. So now I take it a variable I equal to, so uppercase within the double quote assembly quote in our string. So Tamil. So print I dot function name is upper. So we know that it is all characters are uppercase. Now it's not J variable print. So J dot is upper function. So here the first letter start with uppercase, but another character are small letter. That means it produces a false in our output because we will check all the characters are uppercase. All the characters uppercase will automatically produce a true in our output. Suppose there is one character is small letter, it will automatically produce a false in our output. So next we are going to see about the is decimal function. So it will check all the characters as decimal numbers. Normally 1, 2, 3 we know that is decimal numbers. So all the characters. So here I take the example for k variable. So in k variable I can use within the single quote, double quote, inverted string. So here we check with print type of key means, so type of key used to what this variable is called, data type is called in particular variable. So we know that str is a string. So here is a string. So now this thing's every characters are decimal numbers. So now we check it print. So k is decimal. So we know that it is a decimal numbers. Now we take it as k variable equal to Arun 1, 2. So print here is there is a characters are present in our alphabetic characters are present in our particular string. So that way it will automatically produce a false in our output. Because it is a character, so normally the alphabetic characters, that way it produces a false in our output. So now we are going to see about the isDigit function. So isDigit function used for the substring. So in substring all the characters are digit mean it will produce a true in our output. Suppose there is a fraction value available means, fraction means a float variable available in particular string means automatically produce a false in our output. We see the example for it. Now print. So here take it as substring 2. So this is a substring. So I check with function is digit. Now check, this is a digit number. So this is normally we know the digit. So it automatically produces true in our output. Now I give point to, so final fraction values is to digit function. So we know that it automatically produces a polynomial because it is not a digit, so it is a fraction value. So now we are going to see is alpha. Our function is normally the string contains of all the characters are alphabetic. Normally we know that English word letters means it automatically produces our true in our output. Suppose there is any numbers are available in particular string, means it automatically produces a false in our output. We see the example for it. Now take it example print. Here I take it a Python. So Python is, we know that it is a alphabetic characters. I check with this alpha function. So we know that Python is a characters, all the alphabetic characters. So that way it produces a in our output. Now check with print Python 3. So here the number is present here, that means it automatically produces our calls in our output. We check with example, so alpha, because it have a number value, that means it produces the calls in our output. Now we check with is all num. So now we check with every particular string have a letter, decimal number, or digit is always produced true in our output. Suppose there is a special character like hash symbol, at symbol, so there is any symbol present in the particular string, means automatically produce our false in our output. We see the example for it. Now take it a variable a equal to, so test 1, 2, 3. There is also present our character also, uppercase, lowercase, and also digits numbers are present here. So numbers are present here. Another take it a variable test at. So now we check with print a dot function is al num. So we check with every particular string have a character have a alphabetic and also the decimal number, so it automatically true in our output. Now check with print b variable dot is al now function. So we check with every particular character have a alphabetic and also symbols. So symbols mean automatically produce a false in our output. So we get a false in our output. So this is the example for comparison functions. So thanks for watching this video.